Democrats decided what the American people would see and when. The Democrats decided the timing on the release of important pieces of transcripts. They still have not released the transcript of the IC Inspector General. And so the Democrats essentially stacked the deck in their favor. And despite the fact that they did this, and even with every unfair advantage and unprecedented advantage they gave themselves, including preventing the president from having any access to the proceedings, preventing his counsel from having any participation in the proceedings, they now have come out of this and fundamentally failed to prove their case. So we're going to be moving into tomorrow, where we're going to have a panel of constitutional scholars, liberal law professors predominantly, and one Republican witness. And the Democrats are now going to be asking them questions about whether or not the behavior that they are inaccurately and lacking in fact, the behavior that they're describing would be impeachable. We would remind the Speaker of the House once again that the power of impeachment rests with the House of Representatives. The Constitution does not say that impeachment shall be the responsibility of a panel of liberal activists, but that's where we're going to be tomorrow. So, in the meantime, we are very focused on the important and critical work that's not getting done. And on that point, I would also just note that the Intelligence Committee has been hijacked for the last 70 days, unable to and unwilling, because the Democrats are in charge, to focus on the real threats that face this nation. And the Democrats will be fundamentally accountable for the damage that they're doing, because the Intel Committee has not been able to focus on critical threats like the threats that we face from China, the threats that we face from Russia, the threats from North Korea, Iran, terrorism. None of those things have been in the purview of the Intel Committee, because they've been focused on this sham impeachment effort. With that, I would like to turn things over to the Republican leader of the Judiciary, Mr. Collins, to talk more about the hearings tomorrow.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Well, as you will find out tomorrow, the sideshow of the Schiff report now is coming to the Judiciary Committee, where it should have been to start with. If you're going to do an impeachment, it should have been in our committee to start with. But the committee failed miserably on so many counts this year that it was actually taken from us. But it's coming back tomorrow, and what's more sad about tomorrow is we're coming back not with what you have always seen in impeachment. If you go back into the history of Clinton and Nixon and all, that comes to the Judiciary Committee with weight and gravitas. It does not anymore. In fact, it's a shell of itself, the Judiciary Committee is. And how are we going to start that? We're going to start it with let's talk about what an impeachable offense is. When most of this committee on our side, on the Democrat side, has already said we need to impeach him. Well, if they already know they need to impeach him, why are we wasting time? I'll tell you why. Because they have a problem. They're having a problem dealing with the facts that just came out of public hearings and private depositions. They're having a problem because this will be the first impeachment that has ever had with honestly not just disputed facts on why they want to impeach the president, but actually contradicted facts on, was it a quid pro quo? Was there actual pressure? Was there anything actually done? When the two participants on the call, the President of the United States and Mr. Zelensky, both said nothing was wrong, and Mr. Zelensky has said many times over, we felt no pressure. We'll talk about this more tomorrow, but I also want to just focus just a moment on what is going on in our committee. My chairman cannot tell you if we're going to have a fact witness call. My chairman cannot tell you what we're going to do really past tomorrow, because he's still looking at it about a presentation and how we're going to do it. How are you supposed to go to the American people with a straight face and tell them that you're actually looking seriously at impeaching a president and overturning 63 million votes, and you don't even have a plan for your own committee? And there's also one very large thing. Our chairwoman actually stated about the things not getting done and how this has been bad. But we have a saying down south is when something's going to be important, my mom would tell me, you're going to go on, I want you to go put your Sunday best on, and we're going to go to town. Well, a few months ago, the Democrats put on their, quote, Sunday best, and they said, we're going to have rules for impeachment, and it's going to take care of everything, and we're going to actually take care of the president. The president will have a chance to actually be a part of the process and look at witnesses and question, and this is where we're at now. The Judiciary Committee was the only place to do that. Well, starting tomorrow, they fail miserably in trying to provide any modicum of fairness in this process. The president's not sending a counsel tomorrow, and he shouldn't send a counsel car, because there's nothing for them to ask. Why would they want to sit back through a constitutional law class, which most of them had to suffer through in law school? Tomorrow provides nothing except a dreary-eyed, drowsy appraisal for this country to watch as the impeachment process slowly drags on with no direction, no focus, because they're having one big problem. And the big problem is the president did nothing wrong, and they can't prove it. With that, I yield to the whip.
Thank you, Doug. Welcome back. Hope y'all had a great Thanksgiving. I wish we had come back here to confront a lot of the problems that families are facing across the country. I wish that we were this week taking up the bipartisan package of bills that passed out of Energy and Commerce to lower drug prices. That had unanimous support, in fact, that would lower prescription drug prices, bring more generics to the market quicker, to lower health costs for families. But we're not doing that. I wish that we were working here in Congress to support what President Trump is doing right now in Europe to strengthen NATO, working with our allies.